you are not expecting to see me in such a manner. Similarly, you don't expect radiation emitting out of a black hole. The hungry monsters promise nothing comes out. But if nothing can come out of a black hole, how can they emit something?
Actually, the mass of a black hole is analogous to the tone of a black color. To decrease the mass, it is not required that matter must be removed from it. To lighten the tone of the black color, nothing needs to be removed from it. Just its inverse should be added.
Now, let us understand what happens during this phenomena known as Hawking radiation. The particles that a black hole emits come from the vacuum surrounding it.
The vacuum of space is not empty. It is filled with various fields. Vacuum is just the lowest possible energy state of these fields. But this value keeps on fluctuating. Matter-antimatter pairs of virtual particles, which are responsible for these fields, keep on getting created and annihilated in the vacuum of space, just like white and black colors. But when this happens in the vicinity of the event horizon of a black hole, it is possible that one of the particles falls into the black hole and other escapes to infinity. As photons are their own antiparticles, it doesn't really matter which one falls or escapes. The falling particle gains negative energy, while the other gains positive energy and gets converted into a real particle by quantum magic, and we see it as radiation. The particle with negative energy behaves like the white color and decreases the mass of the black hole by E equals mc squared.
But this explanation is not perfect. This phenomena actually occurs at quite a distance from the event horizon of a black hole.
Hawking radiation can be thought about in another manner.
Imagine that I am traveling in a car at constant speed of 10 meters per second. I just zoom past you and you don't notice anything unusual. But now you are sitting in another car and start chasing me with a constant acceleration of 1 meter per second per second. Now, in your frame, my kinetic energy is decreasing. But hang on, that energy has to go somewhere. We can assume that it gets converted to thermal radiation. This was just heuristic, but it can help us understand how hot gas particles, which were absent in one frame, can come in another.
According to the Unruh effect, vacuum emptiness is relative. A detector experiencing acceleration can detect the hot gas of particles in vacuum. However weird that may sound, it is possible, but at very high acceleration. As we know, vacuum has energy, and that creates this effect.
Time to fasten seatbelts, my friends. Gravitation and acceleration are the same things. The role played by acceleration in Unruh radiation is played by the gravitation of a black hole in Hawking radiation. The temperatures due to these have highly similar forms. This is even sometimes called the Hawking-Unruh temperature. In fact, Unruh radiation can be thought of as the near-horizon form of Hawking radiation.
The slow death of the monster helps us to understand how unexpected things can happen if we combine the two great achievements of the 20th century, quantum mechanics and general relativity. However, the end of our ride is just a beginning towards the theory of everything.